The ABC pants. Do you know about these pants?
I don't.
You do? Well, John's here, and we'll talk about this in a second. But joining us now for a broader look at the market as well, as Wall Street gets underway for its new week, is John Koudounis. He's the CEO of Calamos Investments. Julian Emanuel, Managing Director and Chief Equity and Derivative Strategist at BTIG. And what I love, I think, about this conversation is we have a bull over here. I think you're still bull. Are you back to being bullish again?
3,000 zero
okay.
price target.
And I have defense playing over here, correct?
Well, I'm cautiously optimistic. So
what does cautiously optimistic mean?
I'm still bullish. I think we got a decent amount of run left in this market. But I think we also have to protect ourselves from the downside, because at some point, going
through this
volatility.
This guy's putting all his chips in over here. He's not. There's no defense over here, right?
3,000 at the end of the year is only 8 points from where we are.
If you look at it, we've been in a trading range for 4 months. Rates have gone up, rates have gone down, et cetera. The most interesting thing to us about the month of September is that, you know, we actually think that the bond bubble burst in the month of September. And what you've seen for the first time in quite some months are inflows into equities. And to us, that's the recipe for higher prices.
Does the Fed cut again?
No.
Not this year at all?
Nope.
I don't think they should, and I don't think they will.
And what is that? But hold on. But that's been the basis of a lot of this run. And that's why I'm curious why you think, both of you, if you're even cautiously optimistic, think that the run will continue.
Well, why would the Fed cut? If they think they need to spur the economy, they're going to cut, right? So if they don't cut, then they think things are well. They're going well. And I don't think they should have cut last time either.
You don't?
Look, what's
if they hadn't, where do you think we'd be?
Well, I think it would be negative for a bit, but you got to look at what has that done to Europe. Where are rates? Negative rates never really helps the economy. At the end of the day, right, you might get a little bit of a boost, but it's not really going to help the economy. So I don't think it was necessary. But there's a lot of pressure, and given the spreads versus the other parts of the world, they thought it was necessary to ease the market. But I don't see another cut.
This optimistic plan of yours, what does it entail?
Basically, if you look at it, the Fed raised their economic projections for next year above their long-run potential growth level. And at the same time, inflation is actually bumping up towards 10-year highs. And so from our point of view, what you're going to see is the Fed, they're going to worry about the repo. We just talked about that. They're going to
What are you buying? What are you buying in this
Financials. Absolutely financials. Higher rates are great for financials.
So the value rotation continues.
We think so.
Okay. Mr. Cautiously optimistic, but I'm defensive, buys what?
Well, I think that you need to look at the different sectors that can take this volatility. So I think what we have that's been doing really well is a market neutral, where you're hedged on the downside, but you have a lot of the upside. Convertibles do that a lot as well.
Would you touch financials?
I think financials are okay. We like healthcare still. Right. We like technology, mostly in the software products.
Okay.
And I think some of the consumers.
You want to play defense, and yet you want to invest also in software, which has some of the highest multiples in this market at this point.
Well, it's the way you invest in it, right? So
it's
the type of products that you put it into. We're not talking just going long
equities.
The equity markets. We're talking about a hedged equity product. We're talking about a market neutral. We're talking about a long-short type strategies. So liquid alts is something that we've done really, really well with in the last few years. In fact, we're one of the top three in liquid alts in the world, and we have the biggest liquid alt fund market neutral in the world as of last month. And people shy away when they're scared, but we think you need to be in it, but you need to be in the proper stuff.
Okay. John, Julian, thank you. We got to leave it there. Appreciate your time. Come on back for more.